Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to another quick edit video from the Swiss Alps. This time with the long exposure sunrise image, which at first I wanted to do as an HDR shot, but I think in this case I can make use of the huge dynamic range of my camera and fix this as a single exposure. So here I just want to apply some warmer color tones, maybe add some glow, and in general just fix the darker areas of the image. For the editing I will be using Adobe Lightroom Classic, and maybe take a look at the Nick Collection plugin, but first, here are the before and after images. Alright, here we are in Lightroom. Let's go to the lens corrections first and activate those two settings. Then I'm going back to the top. And for the profile, I'm going with Adobe Standard, since this will already help by brightening up the shadows just a little bit. For the white balance, I want to have some warmer colors in this image, so I'm increasing the temperature. Maybe I can also increase the tint just a little bit. Alright. The exposure does actually look quite good. I just want to drop the highlights so we get some nice details from the clouds. Then I'm also increasing the shadows to restore details from the darker areas. And I'm also carefully increasing the whites to get more brightness out of this image. At this point, the image starts to lose some contrast, so let's drop the blacks. Also, I'm adding general contrast. Okay, nice. I think I want to have a subtle soft look over this picture, so for this reason I'm dropping the texture just a bit. Also let's increase the clarity a little bit, and then I can add some more brightness by dropping the dehaze, and this will also help create this soft look. Okay, nice. Let's boost the vibrance for some more saturation. And then let's do the local adjustments. For this image, there isn't that much going on. Let's start with the gradiated filters. You can see I have applied one outside of this image. That means this filter covers the whole photo. And that's because I want to change everything here except for the highlights. And for this reason, I'm applying a luminance range mask. So if I drop down the range here, that means everything except pretty much the clouds with those bright areas will be affected by the change. And since I want to brighten up those areas, I'm increasing the exposure. Also, the shadows are a little too blue, I think, so let's increase the temperature. And let's also add some contrast. Alright, nice. Then I have applied two radial filters on this image. Let's work on this house in the foreground first. Again, I only want to affect those brownish color tones of the wood of the house. So here I have applied a color range mask. And with this eyedropper tool, you can see I have selected the color from the wooden area of the house. And here I'm simply increasing the exposure again. Also, let's increase the shadows and add some texture for more sharpness in there. Okay, then for the final radial filter, I just want to apply some nice glow in the sky. Therefore, I'm increasing the blacks. And I'm also dropping the dehaze. And then I could warmen up this area a little bit by increasing the temperature just a bit. Alright, that's it for the local adjustments. Then let's do the color grading. I want to start in the HSL tab with the saturation. For this shot I want to boost the orange tones as well as the yellow tones. And let's drop the aqua tones and the blue tones to fix the blue color cast of the snow. Alright, then that's it for the HSL panel. Next for the split toning. Here I want to start with the highlights, and I'm applying a warm color tone here, which will make the sky a lot warmer. Okay, then for the midtones, again I'm using a warmer color tone. And then for the shadows, I could apply a cold color tone, just a very subtle one. Okay, that looks much better. Then let's do the sharpening real quick. And finally, let's go to the calibration tab all the way down. And here I just want to boost the saturation of those three tones. Okay, that looks really cool. Now I think I can spot some sensor spots, so I'm using the spot removal tool right here to remove them. Okay, now that's pretty much it for this image. But as said in the intro, I want to check the Nick Collection plugin. So let's right click on the thumbnail and edit in Color Effects Pro 4. Alright, and here let's just boost those nice sunrise colors a little more using the skylight filter. And when I turn up the strength, you will see those warm highlights will get a bit stronger. I think this way it looks pretty cool. Also, let's add another filter right here. And here I want to go with the polarization effect, since this will also help with those sunrise colors. The upper part of the image does look really cool, but I think the hut in the foreground is a little strange. So let's remove that part by creating a control point. Just like this. Okay. Then let's save it like that. And here we have the final image. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions left, then feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.